Hello, dear ones. It's Alice. I have a fair amount of information for you on how to overcome the demon world today, and it'll be a little bit rambling, but I think most of it is new information for Earth, and so I think it's worthwhile hearing about it. There's, first of all, I should mention code words in the demon world. One of the code words that I've run into quite a bit is the word Rotterdam. Now, I think this is a city on Earth, but it's a phrase that is frequently repeated in the clairaudient communications of the demon world. And I believe it's one of the code words for demonry. So if you hear this telepathically, I would take great pains not to reproduce it in my own unconscious mind or semi-conscious or sublingual clair talk. And there are other code words that they use, such as you have no personality, and no love on the internet, and quite a few others. So these code words, they have something to do with the work they do, which I'll be discussing in a minute. All right. So just if you notice these kinds of repeating phrases, which will probably be changing from time to time, just in your own communications on the clair plane, try to avoid those phrases, okay? Because I think they have some, like, significance. The next thing is something that I found very interesting, and that is that the demons with which I've been, like, negotiating today and the day before are of electrical in nature. And this gives you an idea of how to deal with them. And I'll be talking about dealing with them a little later, how to help them decide to evacuate your own soul field. Okay? And so that will be welcome, right? A welcome situation that I'll talk about farther down. And so they're electrical in nature. And that is why when I see them, I see them as like a distortion of the air, not as like a colored, they're astral in nature, and they're transparent to me. Others may see them differently, but they seem to be distorting the air, and that's how it's disturbing the molecules of air, and that's how I can see them sometimes, very rarely, but once in a while. Okay. So what does this mean, that they're electrical in nature? Well, for one thing, it means that they being astral and we being physical, and we being right now in the process of ascension, and in that process, most of us, or some of us, being in the process of joining the astral realm, the fourth dimension with the third dimension, we're beginning to actually sense and see them, okay? Because we're joining to our awareness, our sensory awareness, the fourth dimension in which they dwell. That'll be the dreamtime dimension that we experience when we're asleep and after we pass on between incarnations, okay? So now I'd like to talk about the role of electronics in this. There is something about electronics and electricity. The internet, the PDAs, the cell phones, right? And the television screen. that is compatible with the physical nature of the demon realm. And what that means is that there's some quality of energy in these items that allows them to promote their agenda towards humanity. Now, I know that sounds a little upsetting, but I would like from a larger perspective to just mention that as we begin to join the fourth dimension with the third dimension in our awareness, there are bound to be technological things in all over the world that in some way approximate the way that things work in the fourth dimension. In other words, as awareness of the working of the fourth dimension increases, the creations that happen here on Earth become more merged with the way that the fourth dimension creation is. And that, in fact, accounts for the fact that suddenly computers were discovered and the internet was discovered, and all these special inventions like the PDA and the cell phone, the television, especially the new smart television, and the smart things that are in the cars, okay? All of these things can be like hijacked by demonry to promote their own agendas, as well as serving the purpose that humankind intended them to be, okay? It will be our job as humankind in the coming years to discover the ways in which our technology aids hostile alien life forms and to eliminate those, to eliminate their ability to manipulate our inventions to their own ends, because those ends that they have are hostile to those of humankind. Okay? All right, so that was quite a mouthful. As you know, people are becoming more like telepathic. Telepathy is really a feature of the demon realm. If you look in your Bible, you'll find many good descriptions of what's called in the Bible Satan. Okay, I've written about this before. I found a good website, and I quoted it on my website. They use such terms as the prince of the air, the prince of lies, the person who talks in many voices, and other descriptors that exactly fit this particular type of hostile life forms' qualities. Okay, so what else can I tell you here now? All right. What they like to eat is our light distorted by a negative quality, a negative emotion. They know that we're beings of light and love and joy, and so their work amongst us is to change our emotions to a negative form which they can assimilate, which they can live on. And they do this by invading our etheric net. I don't know if you know what the etheric net is. It's one of the bodies, a template, like the blueprint of the human form. And it's one of our many bodies. And so, for instance, we have a physical body, an emotional body, a mental body, the etheric net or the etheric body, and then goes on, causal body, light body, soul field. So to get back to the etheric net, this etheric net is actually like the internet, that the physical internet, it has some qualities in common with that. And through their electrical nature, these demons can, I know this sounds very far out, and to me it was very far out too. I should tell you, you know, so that you don't think that I've just blown it, that they are the prince of lies, so they might be lying about the whole thing, you know? And so consider these things that I'm saying and see if they fit your situation, okay? let's see. What they do is they land on the etheric net, and what they can do is create through attaching words. Actually, I don't know how they do that. They attach words to parts of the etheric net that should be separate and somehow glom them together. These words must have some negative import to the particular person's mind. And so at night, during the night, they spend their time glomming together parts of the etheric net and creating the propensity to have a negative emotion in certain real life situations. These tangles that they create in the etheric net have been known in many religions and in many spiritual schools. They are called by such names as samskaras, morphogenic field distortions, and in the Bible, they are sometimes called tangles. And they can be changed very easily by these beings. These beings are highly intelligent. They are very very scientifically advanced, and they have been taking advantage of humanity as a form of food, actually, for a long time. Now that the ascension process is taking place, we're coming into awareness of them, and we will have the ability to rid our planet of them. We are a free will planet, and we can do that. I'll get back to this topic of the rest of the conversation in a minute, but I just thought I would interject a conversation that I had with them today. It seems they're hierarchical in nature, that they believe that they're here well. They purport to be here legally on this free will planet through contracts that legitimize their stay here. The subject of these contracts is our permission to them to take away our free will. I think I'll be putting out more on that later. Actually, the Christians have a great deal on that. Contracts, they call it with Satan, but I say with the demon world because there are so very many of them. On one human etheric net can exist a colony of hundreds, I suppose. I couldn't say how many. So anyway, I was talking to them today about what they call the sin of pride or arrogance, which they feel gave them permission to inhabit my form as their space station that they would colonize, as they so tenderly call it. And I was trying to get down to why they felt I was arrogant, because I don't think of myself in that way, you know. And I think of myself as a servant of God. I think of myself as doing God's will insofar as possible, although I think there are quite a few instances in which I fall short of this goal. I take Christ as my leader, and I believe in the Christ-like consciousness. So I couldn't understand why they felt that they had found a way around the free will clause with regard to planet Earth. And as it turned out, what happened was they thought that the word arrogant meant that we humans consider ourselves to be good as they are. Now they feel themselves to be far superior because, after all, they exist in the fourth dimension, not just the stupid third dimension, the dumbed down version of reality. Okay, so when we say, you know, be gone or like that, they consider that arrogance. They know that there's Christian teaching against arrogance, and so that is their step into our world is when we oppose them. I explained today that our understanding of the word arrogance is quite different from theirs. We feel that arrogance is not to walk in Christ's footsteps. We feel that arrogance is not to follow the will and the heart and the mind of God in our daily life, insofar as we are capable of doing that. And so, in essence, what has happened is that there's been a misunderstanding or misinterpretation. I won't say whether it's, I think it was an honest mistake on their part. They thought it was just a way in. And so they felt it appropriate to colonize Earth because of that. Because for them, we all seem to exhibit arrogance. And the Christian texts say that arrogance is like the tool of Satan. So I explained all that. I will say it's going to take a lot more explaining because they're stubborn people, they're highly intelligent, they're highly technologically advanced, and they've been what they call terraforming Earth for a very long time. I asked what they mean by terraforming, and they say that this is the most incredible story. I mean, the stories keep changing, you know, Prince of Lies. But the story that has been coming down lately is that they colonized Earth. And they came to terraform like an inferior species. And by terraform, they mean take total control of humanity. That's their intention mentally, to take total mind control of humanity through these etheric net tangles that we were talking about, and through like mind signals broadcast through the astral plane. So their intention is quite the opposite of our intention, and what our free will would say, you know. We need to uncover what it is, what tricks were used to allow them to be here and help them, help our teams deport them from this place. I can't do it all by myself. Each of you needs to come to awareness of what is actually going on and take the necessary steps to secure your own person, secure your own astral form and your own airspace, as it were, from these beings. So you have to take your own steps. You have to come to your own awareness. And each of you can help humanity to overcome this difficulty. So I was going to talk a little about a very unwanted topic, and that is, how do they use the internet to their advantage? They have a way of getting into getting information from the internet, from our friends, from Facebook, and like that. They have a way of, like, hearing the vibes of internet porn, which seems to be a thriving business on the internet. When they communicate with each other through our friends, like they connect with our friends when we think of our friends in email or in Facebook, like social media or like that, they connect with the terraforming demons in the other person, okay, and exchange information and ways to like continue making us more negative. Because the more negative we are, the more they like us as a food base. So it's not all as bad as all that. I'm going to come to some stuff that will get rid of them very quickly, okay? So they're very tricky. They can somehow ratchet up the vibes of lust on the internet because of internet porn, especially after 3 p.m., okay? They can ratchet up those vibes so that they actually come through somehow on the airwaves of the internet and affect our hearts and our own electric fields. And so in that manner, they hope to degrade the emotions of the second chakra from positive co-creative potential to negative, lustful, object-based behavior. And they have been making hay while the sun shines in that way for a few years now. Oh, I meant to mention that another technique that they use to change the second chakra energy from positive to negativity has to do with a story that they've told over and over again, which has apparently been transmitted to a lot of people. And that is it's a kind of a black magic story, and it has to do with the notion that a man's semen is cursed, and that he can use that semen, he can place that semen someplace, like at someone's house or who knows where, where it will. It will drag that person down into the demon world. I just like to say that this is a total fantasy. Second chakra negative fantasy. And that the semen of a man is a gift from God intended to create new life on earth. Not a curse, but a gift from God. And so, as we go along, we will discover more and more of these black magic, witchcraft, sorcery stories that are deeply hidden in the subconscious mind, and bring them to light so that we can once more experience the wonderful positive energy of the second chakra. This is just one example, because they work with all the chakras to try to make them negative. And in the case of the heart, they create like nets around the heart chakra that have words in them, subliminal words that constrict the heart energy. And the reason for this is they know that as the ascension process, they are very intelligent, extremely intelligent, and hierarchical in nature. And they know that as the process of ascension goes on, as we begin to feel our hearts more and more, as that heart energy ratchets up, or even if we do a lot of kundalini yoga and increase the flow of kundalini in our bodies, we become uninhabitable. The space station that they call each person a space station, right, on Earth, which they're terraforming, that particular space station will become uninhabitable. So at this juncture in the ascension process, they're doing everything they can to prevent us from feeling our hearts. And those tricks are many, very many, all to be eliminated simply by placing the hand on the heart and feeling the heart every possible moment. Or as Sandra Walter says, we can imagine and speak the tone hue, meaning human. We can speak that tone hue through our hearts every time we feel that some kind of compromising energy. Like this. Well, sort of like this. Hugh. 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 I'm feeling my heart as I do that. I can feel like the energy of the sound coming through my heart chakra. Feels great. So onward and upward.